I'm not using a stuff sack for my sleeping bag because stuff sacks are really time consuming. So I just try to compress my sleeping bag with the weight of all my other stuff so I don't have to deal with stuff sacks. And I put my sleeping bag liner on top of that, and then my lightweight tarp is actually a tent tarp, which is really cool. And then I put my rain fly and my rope to hang my bear bag on top of that. And actually, you don't need a rain fly for your tent if you have this tent tarp. You just hang or position the tent tarp on top of your tent, like over your tent, so your tent still breathes. I think that's better than a rain fly anyway. So then I put my major huge bear bag on top of the, and my bear bag is just made of a contractor bag. That's all it is. And then on top of that, I stuff my sweatshirt by Under Armour on top of that. And then I stuff my Under Armour leggings on top of that. And then I close up my pack. Notice I have a clothesline hanging across my pack. See, I carry it. I tie it to both sides. And I have this nifty clothespin that I got from the doctor's office. See, he used it so I can hold my nose shut while I'm taking an asthma test. And he let me keep the nose clip, and it can be used as a clothespin. But, you know, I'm going to show you a different method of drying clothes on my pack. Here in the one of the top compartments, I have my chapstick, compass, a really good compass from Cabela's, and a small thing of Dr. Burner soap and some toilet paper. And another top compartment has my rain gear. It has my pack tarp and a waterproof matches case, which has a broken compass on it. It has lighters and other stuff. These are the things in the bag. I have extra batteries. I have a headlamp. I have these lighters, waterproof matches case. I have a bear whistle. A whistle. You blow three times equally when you're in danger, and that will alert other hikers. Hopefully, it goes. That's the signal that you need help. And here's my natural beads, because I'll take these before every meal, because I'll get indigestion on the trail. Yeah, you get it a whole lot more than you do when you're at home. And then in another top compartment, I have my shirt, I have my socks and boxers, and my windbreaker. And I have this medical kit, too, in my top compartment. And I cram it into the top compartment very tight. And then I slap my tent on there. And I put my canteen in the side pocket, and my U-Digit shovel on my belt. And I didn't mention, but I also have my fuel canister with my fuel pump on it, in my back mesh pocket of my pack, and my MSR water filter. Now, see, when I pack up my whole pack here, I have my two thermarests on top, and then I have my pots and my spoon hanging from them, and they're clanging together while I walk. The noise keeps bears away, so I I have to watch them really good because I don't want bears picking up on that smell. Plus, I'm going to hang these boots from this pack because I'm going to be wearing sneakers. Trail, you know, they're made for trails and backpacking. So I have two sets of footwear. I have my trail hiking sneakers and I have my trail hiking boots, which are waterproof, or Gore-Tex. And now prepare for every scenario. Cook with your trail cooking equipment at home. And also dry your shirt on your pack. And take practice hikes around town. And, you know, really get yourself into the practice of hiking around. Now, study your AT companion too. You know, study all your gear. Make sure you have all the stuff that you need and everything. So, have a nice trip. All right, bye. I discovered after a while of washing my shirts, like, you wash your shirt every night and you wear the same thing every day and you practice this before you hike. I have found out that the orange shirt is a cheap polyester shirt from Walmart and it smells like gasoline after the fifth or sixth wash. I found that out. So I'm going to take a cotton shirt from Walmart, which is fluorescent yellow, yellowish green, and you just have to find that stuff out before you make the mistakes on the trail. You make the mistakes at home, so you don't have to make the mistakes on the trail. And that's a smart way to go about things.